This time, you will learn about bottlenecks and takt time. Did you know that all systems have capacity constraints, also known as bottlenecks? The bottleneck is often the slowest process in the system. Queues grow before bottleneck processes. One important insight is that process improvements may have no effect if it does not address the capacity constraint. Therefore, identifying the bottleneck and adding resources to it is often the best way to improve the overall capacity of a system. But the identification of a constraint is often only transitional. When one constraint is removed, another one will appear. Eli Goldratt made a whole theory out of bottlenecks. He called it the theory of constraints. The bottleneck generally determines the pace of an organization's ability to achieve its goal, which is to make profit. Note that the theory of constraints suggests that it may be better to not remove the bottleneck, but to manage it strategically. The overall idea is to make the flow through the bottleneck equal to market demand. And to understand that, we need to introduce the concept of takt time.
The term takt time stems from the German word taktzeit, which translates to rhythm or beat. You should be familiar with the word if you have ever read musical notes or done repairs on two-takt or four-takt engines. The first large-scale application of taktzeit was in an aircraft factory in Dessau, Germany, before the Second World War. Junkers, a major German aircraft manufacturer, produced some of the world's most innovative and best-known airplanes at that time. In an attempt to implement mass production in the Junkers aircraft factory in the early 1930s, engineers implemented a system where the total production process was split into six segments of equal production times, and the production moved ahead at fixed takt intervals. At that point, Junkers had 40% of the international market share. The result was a finished plane every 9 hours, with production numbers as high as 60 planes per month. So, the original definition of takt time is the average time between production of two consecutive units. But note that the modern-day understanding of takt time differs a bit from the original one. Today, we relate takt time more to the pace of market demand. So the new definition is, takt time is the average time between production of two consecutive units needed to meet market demand. Now we can introduce line takt time for the original meaning of takt time. The line takt time should be close to the market takt time. Finally, if we zoom in on each process, especially on a production line, they have their own cycle time. The time it takes from starting on a production order to finishing it. In an ideal plant, the average cycle time is equal to line takt time, which equals market takt time. In practice, it is never like that. Cycle times is almost always designed to be a bit faster than the takt time. Why are these distinctions important? Because if we, for example, add another line, the line takt time doubles, while market takt time remains the same. And if we add a parallel process, the cycle time of that process can double without jeopardizing the line takt time. Since we are already talking about times in manufacturing, here are two other important terms. The time it takes from a customer order to the product is delivered, we call order lead time. The time it takes from we start processing an order on the shop floor until it is finished, we call throughput time. Takt time is a fundamental characteristic of an assembly factory. It is its heartbeat. It represents the pace at which products exit the line or the factory. This rhythm influences the design of layout, choice of equipment, jobs on the floor, organization, even the culture in the factory. Note that the takt time is a characteristic of different industries. You find very fast takt times in pharmaceutical or fast-moving consumer goods industries or process industries, in which assembly is often continuous. Such processes are often or should at least be highly automated. Most human assembly work is done with takt times ranging from 30 seconds to hours. 30 seconds is rare in the West, and most unions would not agree to it. Most car factories have takt times ranging from 1 to 3 minutes. Other products have very long takt times. A Boeing plane, for example, is assembled on a production line that moves continuously at a rate of 5 centimeters per minute, stopping only for worker breaks, critical production issues, or between shifts. The Boeing 777 assembly line operates on a 3-day takt.
So, let's bring the concepts of bottlenecks and takt time together. Consider this chart showing the market takt time for a product and the process cycle times in a single line factory. Where is the bottleneck? Correct. The process with a longer cycle time is constraining the total output of the line. In this factory, one should work to reduce the cycle time of process 3. Improving process 4 would be a waste of efforts. For example, one can move job task of process 3 to process 4, and by that getting all process cycle times under the market tech. Ideally, this exercise should be continued until process cycle times are balanced. Line balancing, which is an important concept to achieve flow, means leveling each process cycle time to meet the line takt time. Bottlenecks are fascinating. They are limiting productivity everywhere. Next time you go to a restaurant, look closely for bottlenecks in the processes. Perhaps you can even spot the takt time in some fast food restaurants. May the flow be with you.